grows well in acidic soil. So requirement here is acidic soil. Acidic means pH of the soil should be less than 7. pH of the soil should be less than 7. Tea contains caffeine, which is the stimulant factor present over there, caffeine. And this activates our or your nervous system. So you are feeling sleepy. When you take a cup of tea, you feel awake, or your ability to work increase after taking a tea. See, you are on a long drive, you are feeling tired. You take a cup of tea, so you can work more. Why? Stimulant activates your nervous system. It makes you more awake. But if you consider the amount of caffeine, it is 1/3 as compared to coffee. So caffeine in tea is less than that in coffee. It is much less, it is around 1/3. Cold drink also contain caffeine. So the aerated cold drink like Pepsi, Coca-Cola, etc., they also contain caffeine. This question was asked by UPSC long back. Cold drink contains caffeine. Beside that, tea contains flavonoids, tannins, volatile oil, vitamin B, etc. They also contain flavonoids, tannin, volatile oil, vitamin B, etc. Other components are also there. Aroma or smell of the tea is due to volatile oil. They change into the gaseous form and that gives you the particular aroma or the smell. So aroma or smell of tea is due to the value of tea is based on the taste and the aroma. You have two main variety of tea. The other also black tea and green tea. Black tea and green tea are the two main. Beside that, if you consider, there are other variety like oolong tea and white tea. Two more are there, oolong tea and white tea. But the main two are black tea and green tea. So green tea contains polyphenol. Green tea contains polyphenol and this lowers the blood cholesterol level. That is why nowadays many people prefer green tea. Green tea is considered to be healthier as it lowers the blood cholesterol level. Green tea lowers the blood cholesterol level. That is why nowadays many people are shifting toward green tea. The propagation or the growing of tea plant is through seeds and vegetative propagation by cutting. You cut a portion of the stem of the tea plant and you place it somewhere else in the soil. Provide sufficient amount of water, nutrient, and it will give rise to the new plant. Now tea plantation or tea garden require porous soil. Tea plant require porous soil, but there should not be water stagnation. It requires water throughout the year, but there should not be stagnation, and therefore tea is grown on slopes. There should not be stagnation of water. That is why tea is primarily cultivated on the slope. It is not cultivated in plain. Water throughout the year, the more is the rainfall, the better is the quality of the tea, but there should not be stagnation of water. Water should move down. That is why it is cultivated on slope. Now, tea requires warm and humid climate, temperature and moisture, so rainfall. Shade management is important. The bright sunlight can damage the tender leaves of the tea. That is why in tea garden you have these tall trees, these trees which provide shade. Silver oak and other many varieties are there which provide shade to the tender tea leaves. In case of green tea, the leaves are dried, whereas in case of black tea, fermentation of the leaf is done. So in green tea, you pick up the tree, you dry it, you reduce the amount of moisture, Whereas in black tea, you would ferment it by adding different type of cultures. Microbial cultures are added and then fermentation is done. And that gives the typical taste to the black tea. Now, tea industry comes under the control of Union government. At present, you have Tea Board of India. You have presently Tea Board of India. And this tea board was set up under the Tea Act of 1953. So the act is Tea Act of 1953. And the Tea Board of India is a statutory body set up by an act of parliament of the central government. And this comes under the administrative control of Ministry of Commerce. So administrative control is of Ministry of Commerce. And the act is Tea Act of 1953. So this tea board is a statutory body. Statutory body means a body that has been set up by an act of parliament. So this is from the, it has been taken from the website of Tea Board of India. Now at present the organization of the board, it has 31 members, including chairman. So they include members of parliament, tea producers, tea traders, tea brokers, consumer, representative of government. So you have 31 members from different aspect of tea, right? From the member of parliament of that particular area, preference would be given to the producers, to down to the consumers, producers and all those in the supply chain. So government tries to take into account the views of the different stakeholder for proper growth of this particular sector. This is the tea map of India given at the website of Tea Board of India. So if you take a look at in this map, tea map of India, you will find there are two major production area. One is on the eastern board, this side, another is on the southern India. So here it is Darjeeling, Assam and the part of northeast. So northeast India, you have regional variety of tea like Darjeeling, Darjeeling tea, which are also in properly Darjeeling. Then you have Assam. In south you have Nilgiri, Munnar, also has good number of tea gardens. So northeastern area, Assam, Darjeeling and these areas, these are the major production area. And in south you have two, Nilgiri and Munnar. Nilgiri and Munnar are the two major areas in South India. So the European planters, they had set up tea state across the country. You have regional branding of tea. Regional, they are sold under the regional brand. Nilgiri tea, Assam tea, Kangra tea, etc. In Western Himalaya also you have two areas. One is in Uttarakhand, but these are minor producing area. Kangra tea. And in some part of Uttarakhand, Kangra in Himachal and in your Uttarakhand. But the quality of the Darjeeling tea or Northeast tea and that from South India is better than that of the Western Himalayan tea variety. Now these different boards such as Tea Board of India, Coffee Board, Rubber Board, Spice Board of India, they come under Ministry of Commerce. So the source is from the government website, Spice Board of India. This comes under Ministry of Commerce and Industry, government. This is under Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Now the Spice Board was constituted in 87 under the Spice Board Act of 1986. Now this spice board was formed with the merger of cardamom board, spice export promotion council, etc. Now this spice board of India is one of the five commodity board that is working under Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Spice board is the one of the five commodity board which is under the administrative control of Ministry of Commerce. And this autonomous body helps for export promotion of around 52 scheduled spices and development of cardamom. So it is working for improving the export potential of different spices. While we were reading this plantation crop, we came across plant. Some of the plant require sunlight, some require shade. So Sciophytes, a plant that loves shade, that requires shade. So they have larger photosynthetic unit than the sun plant or the heliophyte. So Sciophytes are shade loving plant. So their photosynthetic unit or your chloroplast would be bigger in size, whereas the sun plant or heliophytes are plant which required sunlight. So the Sciophytes or the sun plant, they are also called photophobus plant. The Sciophytes or the shade loving plant, they are also called photophobus plant, and they can reach their saturation level or good efficiency with only 20% sunlight. So some of them can even be kept inside your room. So shade loving plant, basically they have evolved and they follow the strategy of optimum use of available energy, and they also conserve energy. So they will be growing in dim sunlight. That is how they have adapted themselves.